We'll be right back. Anderson. Well, if it makes you feel any better, we weren't touring anywhere else anyway, so it's not like we were seeing other people.
In my dream, please! It's quiet!
We've been saving ourselves for you. Actually, the crowd in St. Louis last night, we had a pretty good lay. But in all honesty, just enjoy the music. I hope you're all comfortable back there. And thanks for all making it in. I appreciate it. As soon as I got shit.
Thank you. Thank you.
after this show tonight, all the rest of the shows on our little, on our travels are going to be inside the last night. We're going to get to see that from you. I think this is just like the time of the families. I'm going to introduce this thing to you because it gives me an opportunity to kind of look at
that's your job.
This is an old it was before the band was actually a band. And Stone to Jeff, actually Stone to Jeff.
All he's getting is back of his head.
And I think Mike was there too, but they recorded a scratch version of this, and they recorded it with Matt Cohen, who's sitting right behind here tonight. Anyways, it's called Footsteps.
Thank you.
hot and I'm sweating. You're badass. This song's called Don't Go. Fuck it, we got a day off. We don't have to get to Dallas anytime soon. But Eddie, man, I just thought that you and the whole band might like to, you know, come to Dallas early, you know, have a big old fucking barbecue. Hey, look at this here. I got your big old hat.
Don't mess with Texas, man.
Hey, just an honest announcement. I guess a fence went back in the center, so we're going to play a quiet one while they fix that thing. And be careful, you guys, in the back. Just right in the center. Take care of each other, all right? See if you can make the news. That'd be a real surprise. A crowd at a rock concert actually did positive things last night. Wow. This song's called Nothing Man.
Yeah.
Okay, you know what it said in the paper today? A bunch of bullshit, but besides that... No, no, don't believe anything until you find out for yourself. Anyways, it said the Presbyterians were having quite an argument with each other. All the leaders of the Presbyterian Church. Now, of course, these are all men, because women aren't allowed, but that's a whole other story. This is very curious, it's very significant, because they were arguing that did it actually, was it 144 hours, was it 7 days that the planet was created by, oh God, that's a problem. 144 hours, 7 days, because they realized that the sun and moon weren't created till the third day, so how did they know what a day was in the first two? Oh God, we fucked up. We should have thought about that when we made up this little story. We left a few things out. Anyway, so I just want to say, so they're going to spend $12,000 and have a meeting and figure this out. Anyway, the thing to think about, I think, is how many days did it take for man to create God? That's the one. Anyways, in the end, don't it make you smile? It's just a little. Thank you.
Thank you.
luck to all you in life. Take care, we'll see you down the road. Much love to you from all of us. Ciao!